Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum students. Today I will be discussing with you people very briefly autoimmunity. Autoimmunity. Students, in very simple words, autoimmunity means loss of tolerance to the self-antigens is called autoimmunity. I repeat, loss of tolerance to the self-antigens is called autoimmunity. Students, I recall for your convenience that in human beings, there are two types of antigens. One is called self-antigens and the others are called non-self-antigens. Self-antigens are those antigens which develop during the fetal life and they are recognized by the body's immune system. On the other hand, non-self-antigens are those antigens which do not develop or which do not mature during the maturity of the body's immune system. As a result, during the fetal development, the body's immune system fails to recognize them. When in the adult life, they become exposed to the immune system recognizes them as non-self and starts their reaction. Now students, loss of tolerance to the self-antigens is called autoimmunity. Now students, the characteristic features of autoimmunity is, number one, in autoimmunity, there is activation of self-reactive helper T cells, which are of CD4 type. Activation of self-reactive helper T cells. Number two, characteristic feature. In autoimmunity, there may be cell-mediated or antibody-mediated body's response. Autoimmunity, the immune reaction may be cell-mediated or antibody-mediated. Third characteristic feature, most oftenly, this immune response of the body is antibody-mediated in autoimmunity. Okay, this was briefly about the definition of autoimmunity. Students, now we move towards factors which affect autoimmunity. Factors affecting autoimmunity. Number one important factor is genetic factors. Students, many genetic factors are involved in the incidence of autoimmune diseases in any individuals. For example, rheumatic fever. Rheumatic fever is associated with presence of HLA-DR4 genes. Presence of HLA-DR4 genes, they make any individual more receptive to rheumatic fever, which is an autoimmune disease. Secondly, students, this genetic predisposition is because of relation of HLA antigens, human leukocyte antigens, with class 1 or class 2 MHC genes. Okay, rheumatic fever, then ankylosing spondylitis, ankylosing spondylitis, it is associated with B B27 gene. Okay, genetic factors. Now, familial predisposition. Second factor is students. Familial predisposition. It is again related to genetic predisposition. Certain genes, they are present in the families and they make the individual more prone to autoimmune diseases. Number third, hormonal factors. Hormonal factors. Students, it is an observation that autoimmune diseases, they are more common in women as compared to males. This is because of hormonal distribution. Number four, environmental factors. Students, among environmental factors, the most important ones are bacterial infections, viral infections, here I give an example of pharyngitis. Students, pharyngitis is caused by Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria. Pharyngitis, it is caused by Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria. Now students, the patient with pharyngitis also develops rheumatic fever. Why patient develops rheumatic fever? This is because of presence of M proteins. Students, M proteins are present in the capsule of Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria. When M proteins are present in the Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria, these M proteins, these are also present in the myosin filaments. Of cardiac cells, myosin filaments of cardiac cells. So when patient develops pharyngitis, the body produces antibodies against the M proteins of Streptococcus pyogenes. But because N proteins are also present in the myosin filaments of the cardiac muscles, so these antibodies, they simultaneously react against Streptococcus pyogenes M proteins as well as myosin filaments of cardiac cells M proteins. As a result, patient also develops myocarditis. Okay students, this was about environmental factors. Stop. Students, here you can see association between some microbial pathogens with autoimmune diseases. Here you can see
स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस पायोजेनेस विद रूमेटिक फीवर, कंपाइलोबैक्टर जेजिनाई विद जीबी सिंड्रोम, इकोलाई विद प्राइमरी बिलियरी सिरोसिस, क्लेमीडिया विद रेटर सिंड्रोम, शिगेला विद रेटर सिंड्रोम, वायरसेस हेपेटाइटिस बी वायरस इन्फेक्शन एसोसिएटेड विद मल्टीपल स्क्लेरोसिस. सो दिस इज अ लिस्ट ऑफ माइक्रोब्स विच आर एसोसिएटेड विद ऑटो इम्यून डिजीजेस.
स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी मूव टूवर्ड्स मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ऑटो इम्यूनिटी. नंबर वन, मोस्ट कॉमन मैकेनिज्म इज मॉलिक्यूलर मिमिक्री. स्टूडेंट्स, मिमिक्री मीन्स रिजेंबलेंस. स्टूडेंट्स, मॉलिक्यूलर मिमिक्री मैकेनिज्म इज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द एग्जांपल ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस पायोजेनेस व्हिच आई हैव टोल्ड यू प्रीवियसली. देयर एम प्रोटीन्स इट इज प्रेजेंट इन बोथ स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस पायोजेनेस बैक्टीरिया एज वेल एज एम प्रोटीन्स ऑफ द कार्डियक मसल्स. स्टूडेंट्स, वी कंटिन्यू अवर डिस्कशन ऑन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ऑटो इम्यूनिटी. नंबर वन मैकेनिज्म, एज आई हैव डिस्कस्ड विद यू, मॉलिक्यूलर मिमिक्री. मॉलिक्यूलर मिमिक्री इन दिस केस प्रेजेंस ऑफ एम प्रोटीन्स. In molecular mimicry, students, the best example is common presence of M proteins in Streptococcus pyogenes bacteria as well as in the cardiac muscle fibers. So when body forms antibodies against the M proteins of pyogenes Streptococcus bacteria, these antibodies, they also react against the myocardial cells. As a result, patient of pharyngitis also develops myocarditis. Second mechanism is release of sequestered antigens. Students, in very simple words, sequestered antigens are those antigens which remains unrecognized by the immune system during the development of body. The best example is male sperms. Students, during development of immune system, these sperms, they remain unrecognized by the immune system. When in adult life, these sperms, they becomes recognized by the immune system, the body's immune system recognizes them as non-self antigens. As a result, autoimmunity develops in the body. Third mechanism is alterations of normal proteins. Students, this mechanism is seen mostly with the drugs. For example, procainamide. Students, procainamide is a drug which alters the structure of normal cellular proteins. As a result, these cellular proteins, they become non-self for the body's immune mechanism. And as a result, body develops autoimmunity against its own antigens. Now students, the fourth mechanism, it is failure of regulatory T cells. Students, the regulatory T cells, once they fail to develop, autoimmunity develops. Why autoimmunity develops? Because they are pro-inflammatory in nature. Now, fifth and the last mechanism is epitope spreading. Student, this type of mechanism is mostly seen in viral infections. So, I have discussed with you the five common mechanisms of autoimmunity. Here, I write down some of the names of common autoimmune diseases. Autoimmune diseases. Number one, students, most common, rheumatic fever. Number two, SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus. Number third, GB syndrome, good pastures. Syndrome. And students, around us, the most prevalent autoimmune disease is diabetes mellitus. Most common. Diabetes mellitus. In this case, the body forms antibodies against the islets of Langerhans cells. As a result, there is non-production of insulin in the body. So, this was brief review about autoimmunity. Thank you, students. Allah Hafiz.